Hi, this is Leo. Today I have a very short presentation for the celebration of New Year, year 2021. In Asian countries, including China, we are celebrating the New Year only based on lunar calendar. This is one of the biggest holidays in Korea and China, I believe. Today's topic is about offline blackboard class. The classroom where we use a blackboard is the only way of the future or not? And this is my question. I think it's time for us to change, because after Corona, we already use a different way of teaching using Zoom, WebEx, whatever we use to deliver lecture to other people in the world. It does mean limited inside of the classroom, but also outside of the nations. So every country we can theoretically access in real time to make a smart class in everywhere. So today I'm showing the short history how the blackboard has been invented and used in the classroom. So far, until AD 1800, when we have world first the blackboard. At that time, the board was used a slate plate in Google. When I search, the French, one of the school used maybe small stones to write down on this slate plate. That's the first blackboard used in the classroom. After that, in 1845, U.S. Army developed the chalk, which now everybody using. So this is the blackboard history, starting from almost 1852, year 2000, the chalk base. From that time, every teacher trying to be the actor in the front, and they draw and teaching and talkings. And after about the year 2010, actually it was started from year 2006 when the YouTube is purchased by Google. But actually the iTunes U from Apple already start world first video lesson from their cloud channel, which is iTunes. And soon after, YouTube opened the EDU, YouTube EDU, where the unlimited time of video they can put. So a lot of big schools start to put the MOOC video on this YouTube platform as well. And suddenly after we have Corona, everybody already have a 4G and 5G platform, and they use Zoom, Microsoft Teams, Google Meet, Cisco, the WebEx. All these tools has been published to make a multiple people connection, not only for peer-to-peer like Skype we used early time. And then they use multiple people and also use of screen sharing to have a blackboard screens together. But this one anyway, all this software we call telepresence, or the video meeting program, not the video classroom program. So we claim, I'm actually claiming that iStudio is really making the Zoom class, WebEx class, Teams class. So it can be used in the real classroom. You can imagine this video showing the projector screen in the classroom. Then every student has virtually eye contact. Even I'm watching the students, the camera directly on my face, making my eye contact. This is a part of my pattern of iStudio. So if you look at the diagram here, the BC to AD 1800, in Bible history, more than 5,800 years, the classroom doesn't have a blackboard. We have around 200 years of history using blackboard in the classroom. And then just 10 years ago, the MOOC video become popular, so more classes happening in the YouTube than the classical classroom lessons. And now the MOOC video was a video upload and people watching it anywhere. But now the video lesson is doing real-time interactive from everywhere, which is I call iStudio Live hybrid video. Possibly we can use as you watching and as you feeling watching this video. So iStudio so far has been used for the studio, and now we are moving this device in the classroom to make a live lecturing desk, live lecturing stand, live lecturing auditorium rooms, the stage. So they can use this machine as a opening space, not only inside the office area, but also outside of the world. So iStudio make a really smart class, which means the classroom from your smartphone. So you can see me from virtual classroom. So we are providing the tools how we make a beautiful studio from your notebook, from your machines. So any studio you can create, there are a lot of development we made how novice people without using any 3D designer or 2D designer, they can make a beautiful studio. So students who is watching the small 7-inch or 5-inch screens can feel they are still watching very large space of the classroom. So before Corona, iStudio designed for recording for studio. Now after Corona, we use this one online classroom to make interactive lecture. As you see here now, I'm just sitting in my room without any cleaning. This just looks like this kind of office. The only difference is my background wall is painted green wall. So I just remove all the other part except myself. And this way we make a classroom to make a live lecture. Here's the challenge. What iStudio claiming is, if you look at the local classroom with a Zoom, they can show Zoom here, they can have PowerPoint on the screen. So from this screen, as you see here, we can think of the live lecture. So for example, if we send the video using iStudio technology, using AR, whatever, we can send to another room, same Zoom screen here, or WebEx, or Microsoft Teams, whatever, we show here, so students can feel remote students together. So the online and offline classroom happening, so all the students here and they feel other students in other places while they are watching the PowerPoint here and teacher together in local class. And I still do live mixing to show this one in one screen, so all the students here can watch only here without any deciding which object they have to concentrate, either teacher or the PowerPoint screen. So now if we combine, it's like you are watching my video, I'm combining. So sometimes I show myself big, sometimes I show the PowerPoint big. Sometimes I show the offline students here. And when they have a question, they can make it bigger so everybody concentrates on watching. Imagine I am teaching the classroom, this screen can be an offline class. So students, they can make a question and answer. All the scene change is like a professional program director doing this iStudio doing all intelligence by himself. The question is, if this presentation on this classroom is really make a presentation better than local class where they're watching PowerPoint and teacher, in case the students here select watching this video is better than watching this classroom, that is the definition how we really prove that telepresentation era is coming. So this is what I'm claiming. Telepresentation so far, there was no device, no definition how we make a telepresentation. As the word of telepresentation means, telepresentation is the presentation from remote place. The students who is watching this lesson from telepresentation device, if they believe this is better than local listening of the classroom, we say the telepresentation technology really successfully made. So I already made many proof for this kind of technology, and even we use this iStudio inside of class. So the students who is watching this video is better than watching teacher or PowerPoint separately. So this one really make the same presentation from any classroom in the world, which is really hybrid class. Hybrid class means the local class and remote class has the same thing. The smart class, when the students watching from smart device, will have the same video as here, better quality from the small distance. So we really claiming that iStudio is a device which will really make a teleclass, which never been possible so far, and also we make a smart class, which never been defined in Wikipedia. So the iStudio is the new millennium lecture systems, both for online and offline classroom. No need to learn how to use, and also it will guarantee simultaneously eye contact, and we are emphasizing watching this video is better than normal live class. So iStudio device was this kind of device. Now we develop two different directions. One is iStudio stand, where we put all the machine together, camera, microphone, iStudio machine, and monitors. And the other one is a desk, which can put in classroom or wherever. So this machine is a desk, lecture desk for teacher to use in the classroom or office everywhere. Using small variation of these two devices, we can put in office, in classroom, or in your meeting rooms. After that, we finally make a iStudio, which can turn the classroom, meeting rooms, office rooms, auditoriums into telepresentation smart class. So I demonstrate many the conferences in the office in Korea, and also many classroom we put. We really make one smart classroom. Teaching classroom in elementary school in southern part of Korea in this month. We will prove how the classroom teaching technology will change. So we finally integrate using the meeting software like a Zoom or whatever, but we just use a Jitsi program to integrate so people can make their own video conference platform without any paying money or without any interfering by the traffics. Same time, Moodle is one of the very popular solution for learning management system. So teacher can make a small video and make a question. So every individual student, when they come to the class, they can using smart device to learn by themselves. And when they only have the time to share together, they can use iStudio for make a live lecture there. So all this integration, live interaction part, and the learning management platform and YouTube content management platform, we can really beautifully design the world of the classroom. Once you put this one in the classroom, in the cloud, what does it mean? It can be shared all together. That's why we say this is the way to make a on-tact MOOC class. The classroom can be open to everybody. So we claim after Corona, all online classes which everybody doing now can be shared to create cloud classroom, cloud united schools. After we have a World War II, everybody start talking, world is one. Finally, they make a United Nations associations. Same thing, without any formal association, every schools, every teacher now creating cloud content, cloud classroom, cloud courses. So this one will really make a new platform of the universe. That's what I am claiming. This is the way how we really creating new platform of schools. I hope really iStudio can contribute the world of United Schools. Thank you very much. Hope you have a great year 2021. This is the message from Tarim. Thank you. Bye.